Today, as we are celebrating our third Sunday of Advent, we have a little bit of a shift in our Advent focus. And right away, we can all tell that something's a little different this Sunday, right? By the vestments that we are wearing. Today, we are wearing rose vestments, not the violet that we usually use during the Advent season. Okay, so what's different this Sunday? What's changing a little bit this Sunday? Well, for the first 2 weeks of Advent, the focus can be summed up in the phrase, "The Lord is coming, and we need to prepare." The Lord is coming, and we need to prepare. But today, and for the rest of Advent, the focus shifts to the phrase, "The Lord is near." Not the Lord is coming, but the Lord is near. Very subtle, but important. The Lord is near. Are we ready? And if we are not ready, what do we still need to do? So the Lord is near is repeated twice in our liturgy today. First, it's repeated in the entrance antiphon, and it's also mentioned in our second letter today that we read from the Philippians. The words are these: "Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. The Lord is near." Now, for years, those of us who are a little bit older remember the Latin Mass. The Latin Mass we had with us for 500 years, from the Council of Trent in the 1500s, all the way to after the Second Vatican Council, when we started using the vernacular in about 1967 or so. But for those people, for hundreds and hundreds of years, when they would come to celebrate this third Sunday of Advent, they would hear the choir singing these words: "Gaudete in Domino semper, gaudete Dominus pro peest." That's the Latin for what we just said: rejoice in the Lord always, indeed the Lord is near. And so the people then would refer to this as Gaudete Sunday, Gaudete Sunday. So this is the day of rejoicing. So in the midst of our Advent season of penance, the church wants us to rejoice. But why does the church want us to rejoice? Because in a couple weeks we might be getting some pretty great presents? No. Because there's a lot of beautiful Christmas decorations and it puts people in a good mood? No. Because this year, unlike last year, we may be able to get together and socialize and have parties. It's a good reason to rejoice, right? But that's not why the church wants us to rejoice. The church wants us to rejoice because Jesus Christ loves you, each one of you, so intimately and so much that he wants to take an important place in your heart. And so he is standing at the door of your heart and my heart, and he's knocking. All we have to do is be ready to open that door. And so our reading today and our responsorial psalm, if you were remembering what we just read, they use the words rejoice, joy, or joyful over and over again. We hear in our first reading from Zephaniah, he uses these words: shout for joy, sing joyfully, be glad and exult with all your heart. The Lord is in your midst. The Lord is near. And in our gospel passage, we see that all the people knew the Lord was near, so they were filled with joyful expectation. They had been a people in darkness, but they were a people with hope. Why? Well, because all the prophets that God had sent to them were telling them that the Messiah was coming, and he was going to bring them the light of the world. And so the light was about to shine on them. But they knew, as the light of the world was coming to them, they knew they had to prepare. So what were they doing? They were going up to John the Baptist and saying, John, we need advice from you. What should we do? And John gives them some good advice. What does he say to them? He says, be generous in helping those who are in need. He says, be honest in dealing with others. And finally, be satisfied with what you have and be thankful. Those were very good words, good advice that John gave to those people back then and still is applicable for us today. So today then, on Gaudete Sunday, we are reminded that the Lord is near. How near? Well, he is standing by the door of our hearts and he is knocking. How prepared are we now, this very day, to open our hearts to receive him fully? And most importantly, what still needs to be done? In today's gospel, we see the people asking John the Baptist, what should we do? Perhaps today we should sit back and we should ask Jesus the same question. Jesus, I know that you want to come into my heart, but tell me, what do I need to do to be prepared? Now, Jesus is going to answer that question differently for each one of us, depending upon our own life situation right now and our own state of our own soul and what our own individual needs are. But I would think that for most of us, a few of the things Jesus would answer would be applicable. So when we say to Jesus, Jesus, what should I do? Perhaps he will say to us, I am knocking at your heart, but if there is anything in your heart keeping me out or anything that is not allowing me to fully enter, you need to address that. So he's telling us, make a good examination of conscience. Make a good confession during this Advent season. Do some house cleaning for me. I'm coming in. I want it to be clean. And when we say, Jesus, what should I do? Maybe he will say, you know, when I come into your heart, you're going to have great joy. And the more you allow me in, the greater joy you will have. But you can't keep that joy for yourself. You need to bring that joy to others. So he is saying to us today, be generous in helping those who are in need, with your time, and also, if possible, with your monetary donations. Today is our Christmas Reach Out Sunday. It's the great opportunity for all of us to open our hearts, to be generous, to help those who are in need. So when we say, Jesus, what should I do? Well, he is probably saying, you know, for me to be fully in your heart, all grudges and resentment to others must be gone. So forgive others as I have forgiven you. And if you have hurt anybody, anybody at all, try to make reparation and ask that person for forgiveness. What better time than do it right now in this Advent season? And when we say, Jesus, what should I do? Well, he might say to us, you know, when I walked the earth, I was kind and patient to everybody. So I want you to open your hearts and really work hard at being kind and patient to others. And Jesus may be saying many other things to us. All we have to do is ask him the question, sit back, and let him answer that question. So the Lord is near. So let us fully open our hearts to him, and then we can be filled with joy. So let us remember those great words, Gaudete and Domino Semper, Gaudete Dominus Pro Pais. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. The Lord is near. He's knocking right now at the heart of your door, the door of your heart and my heart. Are we going to open it for him fully? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.